you like to spend your time sitting on the sofa in your underwear with your socks curled up with a cup of tea and a sandwich next to you and thrashing it out on your games console, then coming up next, I'm going to take you behind the scenes and bring you the top computer games. All the best games to get in 2013, so I'll be bringing you all of the latest game news. That's next up here on Storm FM.
What's happening, guys? This is James Blonde with MMOHuts.com with another top video list. This time, we're updating our list and showcasing the top 10 free-to-play FPS games. This list focuses on first-person shooters only and consists of variety, popularity, and some personal favorites of mine. Not to mention all these games are rated 4 out of 5 or higher on the games list at MMOHuts.com. So starting out our list at number 10, Crossfire. Crossfire is a quick-action MMO FPS developed by Smilegate and published by Z8 Games. The game made its way into the free-to-play market in 2009 and started to build up to its current form with 13 different game modes and 30 different game updates. Okay, so the game has had its hard time with a lot of hackers, but plenty of that has been cleaned up recently. Besides, these guys did the zombie mode right. It's not just your simple mutation game mode, it's multiplayer mass zombie mutant extinction. That's how it should be. Right now, the game is holding tournaments in the World Cyber Games, so needless to say, the game is well-established and still holds plenty of dedicated players. Next up at number 9, we've got Gotham City Impostors. Starting out as an Xbox Live Arcade and PlayStation Store games around $15 to download, the game started seeing more success switching to the free-to-play model and becoming available via Steam. The game is actually pretty funny as sort of a satire on both the followers of Batman as well as the Joker. So you can choose your side, create your twisted-looking character with tons of customization, select your loadout, again, tons of customization including grappling hooks, gliding wings for fat guys even, roller skates to get around faster, and plenty of homemade weapons. Then you battle it out in four different game modes, all themed around the sociopathic ideas of the Joker. And to think, the game is popular despite its well-known latency issues. I don't think they're going to fix that. Tactical Intervention falls in at number 8 on the list. Recently picking up a new publisher, Tactical Intervention is known for being developed by the one and only Gooseman, one of the original creators of Counter-Strike. And as the name implies, the game is designed with tactical-based gameplay in mind. Gooseman brought the game outside the box with new tactical ideas like the use of attack dogs, riot shields, and even using hostages as human shields. One of the most interesting aspects of the game is the unique game mode that lets players hijack a car to take part in an intense highway chase while they hang out the window to unload their magazines at a VIP. Yeah, I'd say Tactical Intervention is definitely a fresh taste on team-based tactical shooters. Number 7 is Soldier Front 2. Now, this is one of the more recently released FPS titles published by Area Games. The game is focused around competitiveness, but I really don't feel that it brings in that kind of audience. The game features weapon and gear customization, a realistic aspect, decent graphics, and a unique hero mode that uses the fundamentals of a MOBA game, which I thought was actually pretty interesting and somewhat fun. And with Arctic Combat no longer up for grabs, this game might just be the substitute to provide fun times with friends online. Now this next one is still early in development, but it's popular enough to deserve a spot on this list. Just not too high up. Number 6 is Warface. Unlike most other free-to-play shooters, Warface runs off the CryEngine 3, giving the game smooth physics and shading, advanced lighting, and awesome animation blending. The game features an impressive AI and its dramatic multiplayer co-op missions, as well as class-based PvP set around common popular game modes. It also sports a unique leveling system where players choose an item to level towards instead of having easy access to high-end weaponry. They claim to be in a pre-open beta stage, but getting an early look at the game, I can definitely say it's one of my favorites and worth looking forward to. And now we take this in a completely different direction with number 5, Tribes of Sin. From the original developers of another fantastic shooter, Global Agenda, Hi-Rez Studios claims to have created the world's fastest shooter by incorporating a unique skiing mechanic with jetpacks to really amp up the twitch-based mechanics in a shooter. All of the weapons in the game are projectile-based, making it extremely competitive and perfect for Capture the Flag and its other chasing game modes. Now, the mechanics in the game really take some time getting used to, but there's no doubt it offers a unique experience. But with all its recognition and Game of the Year awards, it's just too bad that Hi-Rez shifted their focus away from this very unique FPS. And speaking of unique, this next one puts a mechanized dystopian twist on the genre. Number four is Hawken. All right, so I'm sure plenty of you disagree with Hawken being in this spot. Maybe it's because it's very niche, but it's actually one of my favorite free-to-play FPS titles. Nowhere else can you get the combined mechanics of a first-person shooter, nearly everything you can ask for in a shooter, that is, and the awesomeness of mechs in a futuristic, desolated environment. The maps are dynamic, the graphics kick-ass, and now with the latest Ascension update, the detail and the customization is through the roof. I've said it before, and I'll say it again, it's pretty damn impressive that a small development team can make a game look and play this good. Sure, every game has its strengths and weaknesses, but Hawken is still badass, and if you don't agree, you can get out. Or, you know, go try playing it again. On to number three, which happens to be Planetside 2. Planetside 2 is the reimagining of an immensely popular game known as Planetside, and should honestly be placed under the definition of MMOFPS. Nothing else deserves that spot more with its three competing factions, territory control objectives, 2,000 plus player battles, more vehicles than you know how to drive or fly, and innovative day and night cycle that can really change the tactical decisions that players have to make. The game is great if you're looking to put a team together and fabricate the role you want to play and take on entire armies of other players. I promise you, if you haven't tried this game, you'll really love the feeling you get the first time you find yourself in a huge firefight in the middle of the night. Alright, so if you're not arguing with the ordering of these titles so far, this is probably where you're going to start. Number 2 is Team Fortress 2. There's absolutely no doubt that this game is a tough contender when it comes to free-to-play shooters. But that's what happens sometimes when you get a game that does well as a buy-to-play game, only to go free-to-play for the hell of it. But really, Team Fortress 2 deserves to be this high on any top first-person shooter list. The game has really diverse classes to play, not to mention the ability to equip items and further enhance that diversity, but most importantly, it's got so many hats. It's clean of hackers and a pay-to-win model, so if you were to recommend one casual yet competitive shooter that you can get lost in for hours, Team Fortress 2 would definitely be that recommendation. And finally, number one, Blacklight Retribution. Yeah, okay, my personal preference had a lot to do with this one. Deal with it. Nobody can deny that this game is a smooth combination of what a majority of players are looking for in an FPS. With a free-to-play model that lets players try out anything and everything before they buy it, the weapons feel nice and the customization modules that you can purchase are not overpowered, making the game well-balanced. The not-too-distant futuristic feel of the game is nice, allowing for some really awesome technology like the HRV that allows players to briefly see opponents anywhere on the map, not to mention the match upgrades like the minigun or the badass hard suit. Overall, there's not much missing from this game, and I think that it can appeal to all types of shooter fans, and that's what puts it at number one on MMOHut's top 10.
So there you have it, guys, the top 10 games of 2013. And if you're a bit of a games console addict as such, then now you know what to buy if you have not yet already owned them games. Do you agree with his list? It'd be good to know. Let me know in the Storm FM chat room. You're listening to Storm FM here at Spreaker.com. I'm DJ Time in the hot seat, playing you some great feel-good music and bringing you some random stuff, a taste of Diverse FM, a great entertainment station from back in the good old days. It was running for 3 years, building up over 10,000 worldwide listeners. And just as good as Storm is now, Storm overpowered us, but saying that, Diverse FM did close down, and we will be returning, but not as competition, just for entertainment purposes only. This show is very random and very relaxed, and my apologies to you all this morning. It is 19 minutes past one, and let's continue with the program. It's now time to enjoy a little bit of the Annoying Orange and the Saw Clown. So sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Whoa, this isn't the kitchen. What's going on?
Hello, Orange.
Hey, I know that voice.
I was hoping you and I could play another game.
Yay, it's Emo Clown. Hey, are we gonna play Twister? That's my favorite game.
No, Orange. The name of this game is Death Trap.
Cool. What kind of Death Trap?
I'm glad you asked.
Is it a waterbed filled with piranhas?
No.
Killer bees in a pinata?
No, that one never works.
Oh, is it a drunk guinea pig with a chainsaw?
What?
A drunk guinea pig with a chainsaw.
Die, you bloody pig!
No! How did that even get in here?
Well, what is it?
Oh, Orange, don't you see? The death trap is you.
But I'm not a death trap. I'm an orange.
No one has ever escaped me. except for you. That's why I have chosen you to become my apprentice.
Apprentice? What are you, Donald Trump?
No, today you will help me by annoying my victim to death.
What are you talking about?
Whoa, where am I?
Whoa!
Hello, Marshmallow. Want to play a game?
Oh yes, I love games.
Everyone loves games.
And I love everyone. Yay!
Yes. All right, Orange. Your time to annoy him to death has come. Now, begin.
Miss.
No. Begin.
Nope. My turn. B2.
What?
B3?
No.
B5.
Hey, you sunk my battleship.
Hey, Fluffy Face. You look like a mini pillow.
Yeah, well, you sound like a chipmunk riding a rainbow.
It's funny because I do.
Everybody shut up.
Jeez, who cut off Jigsaw's funny bone?
No, don't annoy me. Annoy him.
I'm an orange, you're a mime. Jigsaw's so boring, it's a crime.
That's it. I see my apprentice requires further training. Let this be a lesson for both of you.
No, not Squeaky Fun Guy.
That tickles.
Stop laughing.
My tickles.
Hey, the Donald's gonna take another stab at it.
Come on, you stupid thing. I knew it. I knew this wouldn't work. Orange, you're fired.
Whoa, you really are the Donald.
You, Marshmallow, you're roasted.
Marshmallow, you're a real hothead now.
Stop laughing.
Whoa, you really lit a fire under me.
Hey, stop it, Donald. I don't think he can take any more.
That's it. I'm out of here. Can't take it anymore. I need to get a new job.
Hey, where's Jigsaw going? We were just getting warmed up. Well, thank goodness they scared that guy away. I didn't like where this whole thing was headed.
Some great entertainment brought to you from the annoying Orange and Saw Clown. Another touch of Diverse FM Classic, exclusive to Storm FM this Friday morning. If you have only just joined us, thank you for tuning in and welcome to the programme. Good morning to you, and I hope you enjoy winding down with me. Up next on this evening's playlist, I would like to play you a bit of Pink as she brings you Dear Mr. President featuring Indigo Girls. And continue to stay tuned to your number one more music variety station as we bring you some more great prank call entertainment, Diverse FM style. And a little bit of Akon, Alien, Ant Farm, All Saints, Avicii featuring Nicky Romeo with I Could Be The One, that's the original. And we're going to be bringing you the top 10 rage moments in prank calls. So a lot of entertainment and some great feel-good music coming your way this Friday morning. So lock it on to Storm FM.
La la la. La 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 la. Dear Mr. President, come take a walk with me.
Take a walk with me.
Let's pretend we're just two people and you're not better than me. I'd like to ask you some questions if we can speak honestly. What do you feel when you see all the homeless on the street? Who do you pray for at night before you go to sleep? What do you feel when you look in the mirror? Are you proud? Why? president, were you a lonely boy?